Hey guys, welcome back. Check out what I've got on the bench today. This is an 8S capable stack from Secure, which has an H743 flight controller and a 70 amp 4-in-1 ESC that will do 150 amps peak, which is just insane. I'm really excited to tell you guys about this stack. Secure also sent me one of their ELRS 2.4 gigahertz diversity receivers. I've used a similar diversity ELRS receiver on my Atlas 4 build and it worked out great. You guys have seen this before on the channel. I'll tell you a little bit more about that later on. This is an incredibly modern stack with all the bells and whistles, which makes it very interesting for drone builders considering the price point. Now, if you want to check out prices, I'll put links in the video description below. I don't want to talk about prices here because prices change all the time. Let's just say this isn't a budget stack. It's a bargain premium stack. The stack comes in these basic boxes, but the components are well protected with foam. Mine had no markings on the box to indicate which version was inside, and it came with no wiring diagrams, but all the information is available on Secure's website. The flight controller comes with some cables with plugs that you can use to connect a receiver or a GPS unit, another cable to connect your flight controller to your ESC. It comes with a buzzer, which is a nice touch. Flight controllers don't usually come with buzzers. It has some mounting screws and some M2 self-locking nuts, and you do get a full set of rubber grommets. The ESC comes with some nice long battery leads with 12 gauge wire, another cable to plug your ESC into your flight controller, and another cable that doesn't have a plug on the other end in case you want to wire up your ESC to a different brand of flight controller. We do get a capacitor, and it's nice to see that it has leads already soldered onto it. This is a 680 microfarad capacitor. We get a full set of rubber grommets, 5 tall ones, 5 short ones. I've got 2 of them already installed on my boards, which is why you only see 3 there. And of course, we get an XT60 connector. For me, the biggest selling point of this flight controller is that H7 processor. Most people are going to be able to get away with running F4 processors or even EcoStacks with those AT32 chips. The H743 is a better processor. It's going to be faster and it's going to be more future-proof. Now, if you're a new pilot or you're building up a Bando Basher, maybe it doesn't matter. You probably will never notice the difference. But if you want the best flight controller on the market for a premium drone, H743 is where you want to be right now. There are 2 versions of this flight controller available, version 1 and version 2. Now, normally version 2 is better than version 1, right? But that's not always the case. Version 1 of this flight controller has the MPU 6000 gyro. Version 2 has an ICM 42688 gyro. Now, both gyros are solid and you can get great results from either. However, for most FPV pilots, MPU 6000 is the gyro of choice because it's rock solid and easy to tune. ICM gyros are known to be a little bit more sensitive to electrical noise and they can be a little bit harder to tune. Now, a lot of that can be prevented by installing a larger capacitor to make sure that gyro is being fed with clean power. Notice that Secure is including a larger 680 microfarad capacitor with this stack instead of the more common 470 microfarad, so there must be something to that. In the past, I've installed 1000 microfarad capacitors with ICM gyros and I've had great results, including some pretty high-end builds like this GEPRC Mark V. I've got a 1000 microfarad capacitor jammed back there with an ICM gyro and it flies great. The flight controller I have in my hands is version 1 with the MPU 6000 gyro, and for me personally, all else being equal, I would prefer to run the MPU 6000 if I can get it. There was a time when we couldn't get that gyro. I compared the spec sheets, and the gyro is the only difference that I could find between version 1 and version 2. If I missed anything, let me know in the comments. This flight controller can control up to 8 motors. It has 6 UARTs. It has an onboard barometer. It does have an OSD chip for you analog flyers, and it has 16 megabytes of black box storage, as well as a physical boot button. This flight controller does have dual BECs, a 5 volt 2.5 amp and a 10 volt 2 amp for your power hungry VTXs. It's nice to have a 10 volt BEC because if you guys remember when the DJI 03 hit the market, we had to check the BECs on our existing flight controllers to make sure they would support the O3 without brownouts. Well, it's nice to have some headroom with a more powerful BEC so that we're ready for the DJI 04 or any future VTX that's bound to appear with higher power requirements. Of course, I'm speculating because as of making this video, I do not know what the power requirements of the DJI 04 are going to be. But I'm making the point that having a little bit of extra headroom with your BEC does make this flight controller a little bit more future-proof. On the other side of the board, we do have some plugs, not only for our DJI system, but we have some extra plugs that can be used for a receiver or a GPS unit. Even with the plugs on the other side, you can solder if that's what you prefer to do, and we have loads of solder pads that are nice and large, and they're nicely spaced out to make soldering easier. This flight controller does have 20 by 20 and 30.5 by 30.5 mounting holes. All right, guys, now I want to tell you about this ESC. The coolest thing about this ESC is that it's rated for 8S, 70 amps with peak current of 150 amps, which is just insane to me. That's way more power than I would ever need. But it's nice to know that the power's there if I ever needed it. Maybe I want to do an 8S build in the future, or maybe I want to use some huge motors to carry some heavy cameras or batteries. With this stack, I see over-the-top specs and future-proofing everywhere I look. Basically, all of my needs are exceeded and then some. Another very important thing to know about this ESC is that it supports both BLHeli32 and AM32 firmware. Secure actually has two different models with different SKUs with the different firmware, so you can choose when you order your stack. Since BLHeli32 firmware is not being updated anymore, I think most pilots will want to opt for AM32 firmware to benefit from future updates. I do think it's safe to assume that if you ended up with a BLHeli32 version of this ESC, it'll run fine without being updated. I rarely update my ESC firmware anyway unless I'm trying to solve a problem. If you're in doubt, definitely go for the AM32 version of this ESC. Another thing I really like about this ESC is if you look at these solder pads for the motors, do you notice that, first of all, they're pretty big, they're huge to make soldering easier, and also they're set at an angle. That means that when you bring your motor wires, having them at an angle like that will make it a little bit easier to do some cable management and keep your build clean. As a drone builder, I really appreciate that. We also have built-in ESC telemetry data, premium MOSFETs, PWM frequency up to 128 kilohertz. This ESC does come in two different layouts to fit different builds. Mine's the traditional square-shaped design that has 30.5 by 30.5 mounting holes. The other design is rectangular and it has 20 by 20 mounting holes. And here's that ELRS 2.4 gigahertz diversity receiver. When you buy the receiver, you can choose between two 8-centimeter antennas, two 22-centimeter antennas, or you can opt for one long and one short antenna, depending on your build and where you plan to place the receiver. The receiver comes with the two antennas of your choosing, a cable with a plug for your flight controller, two pieces of heat shrink, and of course, the receiver itself. The receiver is a 2.4 gigahertz dual antenna true diversity receiver. Since it is a true diversity receiver, it is compatible with dual antenna systems like Gemini. It does have a temperature compensated crystal oscillator, which basically means that it'll be able to function properly in hot or cold conditions. It does support high refresh rates up to 1000 Hz for low latency applications. So if you're a racer or a freestyle bando basher, you'll appreciate that. I prefer to run my diversity receivers at a lower refresh rate to maximize range like I do with this Atlas 4. If you do use a diversity receiver like this, you might want to install one of these antennas with different orientation. That way you'll take full advantage of having dual antennas. On this micro build, I really didn't have space for that. With my setup, I've been several kilometers out. I've flown to the edge of my video reception and I've never come even close to having a failsafe. If you're coming from crossfire like I am, and you're used to being able to just fly to the edge of your VTX range without worrying about it, a diversity receiver like this is a great way to jump into ELRS. This receiver does have solder pads as well as a plug, whichever is easiest for you. Like I mentioned earlier in the video, these are not budget or eco components. This is a premium stack and ELRS receiver with all the bells and whistles you could want for a modern FPV drone build. Everywhere I look, I see little extras. It's 8S instead of 6S. The ESC is 70 amps instead of 50 or 55 amps. That BEC goes up to 10 volts. It includes a buzzer, a larger capacitor with soldered leads, etc. These are all small details, but they add up to a very appealing package. If you consider the features that you're getting with these components and the price point, Secure is a pretty good option because most premium stacks sell for much more, and most budget or eco stacks offer much less in terms of features and specs. One thing I don't love about these components is that they don't include any documentation at all. No wiring diagrams, no quick start guides, and the components ship in these generic boxes with no markings or stickers on the box to tell you which model you have other than that little QA sticker. This isn't a big deal because you could get the wiring diagram from the product page and you can confirm which version of the stack you have by plugging it into Betaflight. But I would like to see a printed wiring diagram that I can have with me on the workbench while I'm building, and it would be nice to see a label on the box so I know that the guy at the factory actually put the right board into the right box. I will be using these components in a build, but I haven't decided which frame yet. I do have a couple frames that are just ready to be built up. I've got a Speedy Bee Mario 5 frame and a Flyfish Volador D6, which is a 6-inch dead cat frame. You know, these builds take quite a bit of time, but I love to do them. I just can't do that many of them because of, you know, time limitations. So what frame would you guys rather see a build video of? The Mario 5 or the Volador D6? Let me know if you guys have any comments or any feedback. I'd really love to hear from you guys. If you want to read more about these products or check pricing, I do have links in the video description below. Thanks a lot for watching. I'm glad to have you guys here. I'll see you in the next one.